So I'm going to show you how to wrap this two different ways so you can see exactly how I got it to look like I got it to look in the picture. The first thing we're going to do is do it downward, and then I'll take my wrap and put it up, and I'll show you how the wrap looks on top of your head. So if you have this wrap or if you're interested in this wrap, the first thing you would do is put your hair down or just let it hang. I have mine wrapped because if you've watched my other videos, you already know I don't show my hair on camera. So that's why I have mine wrapped. If you want to protect your hair or if it's really, really cold outside, you can wear a wrap underneath, but you don't have to wear this wrap underneath. So you can put your wrap down, you can put your hair in a downward ponytail, or you can just let it hang down before you put this wrap on. And then you just put it on from the back. Make sure all your hair is in there, and then you just simply pull it up to the front. And this wrap has ridges. It has, if I'm not mistaken, yeah, 5 ridges. So the ridge here should be in the middle of your head, so I'm just going to move that over. Unless you want your wrap to be lopsided, hey, it's your wrap, do what you do. So now I hope you can see that. I just centered mine. I have that ridge going down the middle and then 2 ridges going down the side. And then the other 2 are kind of like coming up at the back. And you're going to have these 2 Snoopy dog ear looking thingies hanging down, and this is what you're going to use to actually tie the wrap. And I like to put these under my ears. I just think it looks cleaner that way and a lot cuter. So I put it under my ear, bring it around to the back, just do a nice little crisscross, bring it back up to the front, well not the front, the top. You can do a crisscross again. And then bring it back to the back. And you have these 2 little ties here. And you're going to tie those together. And then you can just tuck that under and hide that little knot. And there is your downward wrap. You can see when I did the crisscross on the top, it kind of puts like, you know, a little hump. So if you don't want that little hump, just flatten that out and put the 2 straps side by side. See that? And then now the crisscross is over here. If you don't even want it over there, just flatten it out and bring the crisscross all the way to the back. You see that? So now I have 2 straight lines across the top. So you can do it like that, or you can put the crisscross at the top on the side, whatever you want to do. And there's the wrap. The front, the right, the left, and the back. So it's a really quick and simple way to get your hair out of your way, especially if you have locks or just, you know, natural hair that's just kind of, you know, if you have natural hair, you know, sometimes it does exactly what it wants to do. No matter what you do to tame it, it has a mind of its own. So if you're just trying to get it out of the way, this is the perfect thing. So at the beginning of the video, I said that it was going to be 2 ways. It's actually going to be 4 ways, and I'm going to show you how to wrap this wrap. 2 ways if you have your hair downward like I do now, and then the other 2 ways if you have your hair up. So the second way, you still have your hair down, and the front of the wrap, what we did on the first style, is to put this, the band, across the front of your head. Now we're going to take this band and put it at the back. And when you order it, it should have a tag right there in the back. So if you want to do this, I'll just put the tag across the front of your head. I'm going to put it on the same way. Okay, and now since we're using the back as the front, you're going to have two ridges like this. That's on the first tower, remember we had one ridge going down the middle. Now you're going to have two ridges on the top of your head like that. And so because of the way it's made, this part is not going to come to the very, it's not going to come to your hairline. So just leave that open because this will cover up your hairline. And I'm just pulling it up, our two Snoopy Dog ears and ties, or whatever you want to call them. I'm just pulling them up, and you just want to make sure that, you know, that's all straight right there. And we're just going to cross it like that at the top. Bring it back around to the back, cross again. Bring it back around to the front. Now, if you want, you can tie your knot at the top, but I personally don't think that's cute. So what I'm gonna do is just pull this one over and use this one to hold it in place. And then I'm gonna take this one and put it underneath the other. So as you can see, I really didn't tie. I just kinda have them tucked under each other. And as you can see, that's going to give you a nice inverted V. And if you watch my other videos, you know I love that. I love to have wraps that have an inverted V, especially for females. I just think it looks really feminine and really cute. So if you want your hair down and you want that inverted V, this is the way you get it. If you're not going to be doing a lot of movement, this is a really good style because, again, it's not tied, it's just, you know, held. So if you're not going to do a lot of movement, this is good. It's not going to really, you know, come off unless you do a whole bunch. So if you are going to do a lot of movement and you want this style, then I would say just use some safety pins or hair pins or whatever type of pin you can find and pin it down. Or you can go ahead and tie a knot at the top and just kind of pull that knot down to the back. I don't like it with the knot, but it's your wrap, not mine. Okay, so that is the second style. And so now I switched my wrap up a bit. On the first two styles, you notice that the wrap was down. So all I did was take my hair underneath and put it up into a high ponytail, and then I wrapped the wrap around that ponytail. And I'm just telling you that just in case you do want to wear a wrap underneath your, crochet Urban Turban. But again, and I like to repeat this a lot, just in case people miss it, you do not have to have on what a base wrap. It's only, you know, if you want to. So for the third style, you have your hair up high, and we're going to put it on the correct way with the front at the front and the back at the back. And so you just flip it over. If you have on a base wrap, just flip it over your wrap. If not, just flip it over your ponytail. And actually, you don't have to put your hair into a high ponytail, but just beware that if you do not put your hair into a high ponytail and you want this look, if your hair is not in the ponytail, the wrap will probably slip down, you know, because your hair is probably going to fall down, and so the wrap is going to fall down with it. So if you want it secure, go ahead and put it up into a ponytail. And just position that middle ridge in the middle. Put the band how you want it on your forehead. Pull it to the back. Crisscross. Pull it to the front. The top. I keep saying front. Pull it to the top. Crisscross. Now for this style, I really do like the crisscross at the top. You guys remember on the second style, I said, you know, you can either crisscross it or keep it flat. You can do that with this wrap, but my preference is to have the crisscross on the top. And then you pull it to the back, tie one time like I did. You can tie two times, and then you'll have like a little knot, and you can kind of hide that knot. But I like to tie this one time, like that, and take the two ends and just tuck it into the band part. And those should be hidden pretty well, and it makes it look, you know, really nice and rounded and tubular. So I think that's really cute and clean looking. And that's pretty much it. You can see here that the top part looks kind of skinny, and then this part looks kind of fat. That's only because of the way I wrap the wrap underneath. You know what I'm saying? This can fill out. It can stretch. You see that? So if you have a whole lot of hair, do not fret. This baby will stretch. It will fit your hair. So I just want to show you. So just flip it around. And this is the fourth and final style. And so now you'll have the two ridges like this instead of one ridge in the middle. Crisscross to get your V, your inverted V. And I like to pull it to the top like this, give it a really different kind of look. Cross at the back, pull back up to the top, and you can just do one tie, and then you can hide those ends like we did on the first one. See that? You can hide the ends, or you can do, and bring it down a little bit, and do one tie, and two ties, and then hide the ends. And the knot can be really cute. If you don't like the knot, then only do one tie and hide the end. And then you just want to go ahead and position and, you know, make it look the way you want it to look. And there you go. And you can also, if you don't like how high this opening is right here, you can just bring it down a little bit. Okay, so you see this one is a little bit cleaner. It doesn't have the knot, and it's just, you know, real smooth. So you can play around with it. Tie it, tuck it, hide those ends, do it however you want to do it. It's your wrap. The way you wrap it really doesn't matter. Just wearing the wrap itself is going to get you a lot of attention, and it's going to give you coverage for your hair. It's good for the summer because it's breathable. You can see now I'm sticking my finger through it. You know it has holes, and it's great for the winter because you could put a wrap underneath, put this on top, get a lot of warmth. You know, I just love the wrap. So I'll stop rambling. Now you know the four different ways to wrap the Urban Turban, the original Urban Turban. And if you are interested in purchasing our wraps, go ahead and visit our Etsy shop, visit our website, isaycreations.com. All of the links are below. Follow us on Twitter. I just got a Twitter page, so I'm excited about that. Like us on Facebook. Follow us on Tumblr. Find us. We're all over the place. Comment, like, thumbs up this video. And thank you for watching. Peace, blessings, love, and light. God be with you.